लेट मी चेक। So, I'm giving you introduction. I'm Dr. Vidya Kshirsagar, working as assistant HOD in Civil Engineering Department. I'm working as a professor in this department since 2006. And I have completed my PhD recently in last 2 years from the Solapur University, Solapur. Dr. P.M. Pawar sir is my guide. Actually, we have not came into picture together physically yet still. I don't know, you may not be knowing about me, but fine, this COVID-19 is making us to learn many different things. So one of them will be the to teach to the unknown people, and you will learn from the unknown person. Yeah, okay. Still, we will try to make it possible to enjoy the sessions, but I'm not happy with your attendance. 43 attendance is there. I think final count is more than 60 or 70. Am I right? So hope we will be here 100% attendance. So as this is the first lecture, I will give you introduction with the subject first. Okay, as I told you, we will be learning about the subject water supply engineering. Okay, so to make you understand, I will show you the first structure. Okay, you are going to study the subject water supply engineering. Structure I will display. With this structure, you will be able to see. Let me okay, in this structure you can see with the course code CV. I will try to slideshow from current. You can see the structure. I think your class coordinator might have shown this structure to you, or if not, you can go through this. In this semester, you are going to study the 5-6 theoretical subjects. CV221 is the water supply engineering, then building planning and design, then hydraulic engineering, then open elective 1, under that ICT for development, then structural analysis, and then engineering mathematics 3. Okay, so I'm dealing with the subject first, that is water supply engineering, CV221. So this subject is having 3 lectures, and it is also having the practical, 2 hours practical. Let us see how we will be able to conduct the practicals. If that unlocking starts, then we may get together, or otherwise the practicals also you may need to understand through the online forum itself. Okay, then for this subject, ISE 3 ISEs you are supposed to appear, and it is having 30 marks for the ISE. What happened? Okay, 30 marks for the ISE, 70 marks for the theory exam, and 25 marks for the ICA. So total you are going to get 125 marks from this subject water supply engineering. Okay, so this is the structure. Okay, I hope you understood. Now I will go to the syllabus. I will share the file with you, the syllabus. Syllabus copy. Okay, just see here. Punyashlok Ahilya Devi Holkar, Solapur University, Solapur. Under that we are studying. So SY BTech syllabus for the 4th semester of the subject water supply engineering. Teaching scheme, as I explained, the 3 hours lectures per week and then 2 hours practical per week. Total 4 credits are there, and total marks for this subject are 125. Now we will discuss the course objectives, course outcome, and then syllabus, and then we will start the actual syllabus of the subject. So the course objectives: to acquaint the students with the drinking water quality standards and forecast water demands. Okay, so what you are going to study here, drinking water quality standards, and how you will be able to forecast the water demand of the society. Then second one objective of this subject, someone is talking, can you please mute yourself? Abhijit Devkar, can you please mute yourself? Yeah, thank you. Then second objective of this subject, to study the various units of water treatment plants, treatment procedures, and sequencing of water treatment units for various sources of water. Then to enable the students to carry out design of water distribution systems and appurtenances using appropriate methods. Then the fourth objective is to acquaint the students with various water supply systems. Various water supply systems and appurtenances, various water supply systems and their operation and maintenance. So the last part will belongs to the operation and maintenance of water supply system. Then course outcomes. So there are the five course outcome demonstrated over here. Upon successful completion of course, the students will be able to plan and design the water conveyance system. Conveyance system means what? So how to transport the water from one place to another place. That is known as the water conveyance system. For a rural or urban area based on population forecast. Okay. Then the second one is the design various water treatment units, and plan their operation on the basis of raw water quality and water demand. Then the third outcome will be apply knowledge of advanced water treatment processes for individual water purification units. Then plan and design water distribution systems. Then identify operation and maintenance problems in water supply system and suggest the suitable solutions. Listen guys, so this subject, the name itself is telling you the water supply engineering. Okay, so we people are drinking water. So think about the Pandharpur city. Okay, about the rural area, I will explain after some time. So I used to explain this subject with the help of field visit to the water treatment plant. Basically in the Manisha Nagar, Pandharpur, there is a water treatment plant. How to treat the water for the drinking purpose. Okay, that part we are studying under this chapter, subject of water supply engineering. Okay, now this subject, from the raw water source, there may be the two types of source. One is the groundwater source or another is the surface water source. From either of the source, we can collect the water and we can transport that water towards the treatment plant. Okay, so I will give you the example of Pandharpur city. In Pandharpur, we are using the Bhima River water for the drinking purpose. Means that water is the surface water, is it? So keep on talking, guys. So we will enjoy the session, is it? So from the Bhima River, we can transport the water through the pipeline towards the treatment plant. So treatment plant is situated in the Manisha Nagar. As I am talking about the Pandharpur city, I will explain with the locations. So something you will be able to means execute that what is going on, that you may be able to understand. Then in the treatment plant, there may be the different treatment unit operations and unit processes. And then after treatment of that water, this water will be distributed towards the public by using the ESR. ESR is the elevated storage reservoir. आपण पाहिले की नाही पाण्याची टाकी आहे मनीषा नगर मध्ये. जे लोक पंढरपूर किंवा नियर बाय रिजन मध्ये असतील त्यामुळे त्यांना माहित असेल की पाण्याची टाकी पंढरपूर मध्ये मनीषा नगरला आहे, की जिथून पंढरपूर सिटीला, कम्प्लीट पंढरपूर सिटीला पाणी सप्लाय केलं जातं. बरोबर आहे. सो दॅट इज नोन ऍज द ESR. थ्रू ESR बाय द ग्रॅव्हिटी वॉटर विल बी सप्लायड टू द पब्लिक. And then everybody's tap, it will reach to the everybody's residence at the tap. Up to this process, we can say it is a water supply engineering. Kayala kuthun ki naditun pani uchallo, tela transport kelo treatment plant varti, treatment plant madhe tela vegvegra prakarcha treatment dile. Then after proper treatment, giving proper treatment, it went to it is transported towards the ESR, GSR and ESR. GSR for the ground storage reservoir, and then ESR, and then it's sent to the people or the society by the gravity. Okay, then from ESR to the individual consumers, it will reach through the pipeline, closed conduit pipeline. Okay, because it is a treated water and it should be, it should maintain the quality up to the consumer. So that's why it must be transported water through the closed conduit, that is pipeline. Okay, so it will be received to the individual, and until it is receiving to the individual, all these parts can be studied under the water supply engineering. But once the drop of water from that tap provided by the Nagarpalika, from that tap, once it is dropping down into the sink or the basin or the utensils, it starts considering the wastewater engineering. From that spot, wastewater engineering is going to be start. Until we are going to dispose that entire wastewater into the river again. Alag alag sir, that is cycle. So this way you are going to, I will try to demonstrate with, I don't have tab today. I will try to get the tab from tomorrow. So this is the river, you can say. Okay, from this spot, we have collected water. We have to transport that water to the, towards the water treatment plant. Usually the water, ground, surface water sources are at the low-lying area. म्हणजे जिथे लेवल low-lying असते अशा ठिकाणाहून पाणी पिक केलं जातं. सो वी नीड टू हॅव सम पंपिंग अँड ऑल अदर इक्विपमेंट्स आर रिक्वायर्ड, दॅट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इन डिटेल. ओके, देन इट विल बी पंप्ड अँड ट्रान्सपोर्टेड टुवर्ड्स दी ट्रीटमेंट सेंटर. ओके, सो दिस इज द ट्रीटमेंट सेंटर, अँड फ्रॉम द ट्रीटमेंट सेंटर, after the complete treatment by using the various unit operations and unit processes, it will be transported towards the GSR. GSR is the ground storage reservoir. Okay, he je treat kelele water ahe te ground storage, mhanje zaminicha khali jo tank bandhela asto tita store kele jata. Barobar aahe. And after that, it will be sent towards the ESR. Okay, it will be sent towards the ESR. So why we are sending to ESR? Because from the ESR, we shall be capable to provide this water to the public by the gravity. Okay, so this city are going to be consume this water. Okay, now until it is reaching to the basin of that individual consumer, it will be considered as, this entire part is to be considered as a water supply engineering. Once it is reached to the basin or the sink or the utensils, it starts considering and as a wastewater. Okay, so I will again start with the red color, same color. So now from that individual, the water will be collected by using the pipelines. From the different individuals, the water will be collected at one portion, and then it will be transported towards the, then it will be transported towards the wastewater treatment plant. So this will be the wastewater treatment plant. Okay, this is the water treatment plant and this is the wastewater treatment plant. Then after that wastewater treatment plant, it will be disposed into the nearby open land or into the nearby river as it is. Okay, then in the river it will get naturally purified. Okay, when it is flowing through the river, at that time it will get naturally purified, and once it is getting naturally purified, again it will be used for as a source for the water treatment plant. So this way the cycle of water supply engineering and wastewater engineering is being performed. And in the first part, that is water supply engineering, you are going to study about the water treatment plant, and in the second part for the wastewater treatment, you are going to study about the wastewater engineering. Is that clear? Can anybody reply me?
Yes,
ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Okay, now I will explain the syllabus subject to, chapter to chapter. Now, there are two sections. Section one, there are the three units. And section two, again, there are three units. So the section one, we will read first. I request to keep on reading the syllabus. Okay? Section one, I will explain and then you can write. And then we will proceed to the next chapter. Okay, as this is the first lecture, introduction of the subject in detail we will take, and then we'll start the lectures. First unit, unit one is the quantity and quality of water. Quantity, understood, and quality of water, excellence of water, goodness of water. Okay, now, sources of water, quality and quantity of water sources, intake work, demand of water, factors affecting demand, fluctuation in water demand and its effects, design period, population forecast, calculation for fire demand, water quality parameters, characteristics and their significance, drinking water quality standards. This much part we are going to study under the chapter titled Quantity and Quality of Water. Okay, so sources of water, from where you are going to collect the water. It may be river, it may be stream, it may be pond, it may be bore well, it may be well. Okay, then quality and quantity of water sources. Here we will understood about the various parameters of the water. Okay, physical parameter, chemical parameter, and biological parameters. Okay, then intake work, how to collect that. As I told you, usually the water sources are available at the low-lying area, and if it is the surface water, then we need to construct some structures, and that structures are nothing known as the intake work. Then demand of water, then demand of water, how much water is required for the particular city, we should be capable to find out. Once we are able to understand what is the requirement, then we can be able to supply the quantity. Demand and supply, we should be able to patch up. Then factors affecting on demand, what factors, what are the different factors affecting on the demand, how it will get fluctuated, that we should understand. Then the design period, what is meant by design period? For how much period this water treatment plant you have designed will be able to capable or will be capable to provide the service. That is nothing but the design period. usually the design period for the water treatment plant is 3 to 4 decades. I'm saying 3 to 4 decades means 30 to 40 years. 1 decade is the 10 years. Then population forecast, demand of water and population forecast. Remember that population forecast in the sense, how to predict what will be the population growth of the city. That is nothing but the population forecast. Is my voice clear to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you. Then, population forecast, you understood ki, what will be the growth of people in upcoming years. And for that purpose, we need to have some past data. From the municipality, we can take the past data, and from that, the judgmental population we can predict. And that is known as the forecasting or the population forecasting. Why do we need to find out the population forecasting? We have to find out the water demand. If we are staying at a home and we are planning to prepare the food for the entire family, what we will do first, we'll count the number of people staying in the home. Maybe 5, 6, 7, 9, whatever is the numbers. Then each number, each person may eat 2 chapati, 3 chapati. Accordingly, we calculate the demand. Is it? So same here. First thing, we should know what is the existing population, what was the past population, and what will be the growth of population in upcoming year. As the design period, we are considering 30 to 40 years. So we are supposed to go for the population forecast for the next 3 to 4 decades. Then we will be able to supply the, we will be able to fulfill the demand of society in respect of water. Okay, drinking water. Then the calculations for the for fire demand. So there is not only the water requirement towards the drinking purpose, is it? You may know that we are collecting water from the municipality tap. Whether we are using it only for the drinking purpose? No, we are using it for the domestic purpose. In that, what different activities are coming? Then drinking, preparation of food, cleaning of floors, cleaning of car, vehicles, and then cleaning of clothes, pots, then for utensil purpose. So these are the domestic activities, and for the domestic activity, the requirement of water is there. And then this required quantity, not only for the domestic purpose, the municipality is providing the water, but also municipality should take care of the water required for the fire control if it is getting outbreak into the city. Multiple times it happens, there is the outbreak of the fire. And to control that fire, we need to provide the water quantity immediately. And that is known as the fire demand. And it must be available with the municipality, otherwise it should not be like this. The fire is broken and water quantity is not available. Is it? So that is how to go for the fire demand calculation that we are going to study here. Then water quality parameters, as I said about means physical, chemical, biological characteristics or the different parameters we are going to study, and what are the importance of each parameter, why to study, and what are the drinking water standards of that each parameter that we are going to study. Is it? So this much part of the fundamental part of the required basis we are going to study into the water quality and quantity of water. Now I request to copy the syllabus in your notebook for the chapter 1, and then we'll proceed to the next chapter. So before that, write down the title of the subject term, CV221, Water Supply Engineering. And then copy the syllabus for the section 1. Make a separate notebook for this subject. I don't know whether you will be able to appear for the examination as a MCQ test, or maybe the physical test will start. I don't know what is the future. I cannot predict that. I cannot forecast that because the situations are under not control. Okay. So please write down for the unit 1, quantity and quality of water. Mute yourself, Pratik Shinde. Once you're done, you can write a message in your chat box, then we'll proceed to the next point.